students, मैं इंद्रजीत कौर. How are you doing? I hope you are well. मैं थोड़े लिए आज एक इंटरेस्टिंग टॉपिक लेके आई हूँ. तुम सोच रहे होंगे कि घर बैठे भी टीचर ही छोड़ दे. चलो, I hope you will enjoy my lecture. But I think you are missing your school and class as well. So let's start our topic so that we can continue with our studies. Let's start. Chapter of 10th, first is real numbers.
Real numbers.
Real numbers is due to types of numbers, rational numbers and irrational numbers. Rational numbers include integers, whole numbers, and natural numbers. Integers are combination of whole numbers and natural numbers. Negative and positive, both types of numbers. 1, 0, 1, 2, 3, and so on. Minus 1, minus 2, minus 3, and so on. Whole numbers. Whole numbers are numbers which start from 0. 0, 1, 2, 3, and so on. Natural numbers are the numbers which start from 1. 1, 2, 3, 4, and so on. So, in summarize, we can say integer, whole numbers and natural numbers all make rational numbers. Clear? So, we can compute it by a diagram. Natural numbers, then whole numbers, then integers. All these are called rational numbers. Or it is and second are the irrational numbers. When we combine both rational and irrational numbers, these become real numbers. And what are the irrational numbers now? Irrational numbers are the numbers which cannot be written in P over Q form. P over Q form and Q is not equal to 0. Example is under root 2. 1.2345. These are the irrational numbers. Now I will tell you about the Euclid's division lemma. What is the Euclid's division lemma? That is given positive integers a and b. There is unique integer q and r satisfying a equal to bq plus r, where r is less than b but greater than or equal to 0. What it means? Let's divide here. It means A divided by B. When A is divided by B, it gives any quotient Q and say it gives a remainder R. So like you were doing in your junior classes, division, you were checking the division. Like I'm giving you an example. 10 divided by 3. When you divide 10 by 3, you get here what was 10, that is called a dividend, and this is called divisor, and this is the quotient, and this is called a remainder. dividend equal to divisor into quotient plus remainder. Now what is dividend here? Dividend is A and divisor is B and quotient Q plus remainder is R. And where R? R is always less than B. Less than B means less than divisor. But it is greater than or equal to 0. It may be 0 or greater, but always less than B. So this is the Euclid's division lemma. Now we will solve the sum by using Euclid's division algorithm. The sum is find the HCF using Euclid's division algorithm. The 455 and 42. We will first divide these two numbers. 455 by 42. 41 twos are 41, 42, 3, 5. We will divide at 0, so 35. Now we will make this remainder the divisor, and this divisor 42 will be dividend. So divide again, 35, that is 7. Now the remainder 7 will be the divisor, and 35 will be the dividend. Divide again. We will divide till we get the remainder 0. Now we got the remainder 0. So let's start our Euclid's division algorithm. Dividend is equal to divisor into quotient plus remainder. What is the dividend in the first part? That is a 455. And divisor is 42. And quotient is 10. What was the remainder? 35. In the next step, what was the dividend? So that was 42. And divisor is 35. Quotient is 1. And remainder is 7. The next step, the dividend is 35. Divisor is 7. And quotient is this 5. And remainder was 0. When we get the 0, we got our HCF. HCF is now the last divisor, means 7. So by using Euclid's division algorithm, we have find the HCF of two numbers.
इस तरह दियां होर वीडियोस देखने लई चैनल नूं सब्सक्राइब करो। सब्सक्राइब करने लई राइट साइड ते रेड कलर सब्सक्राइब लिखा है, उस नूं क्लिक करो। जे वीडियो पसंद आई तां लाइक करो ते अपने फ्रेंड्स नाल शेयर भी करो।